Well, joining me now are Mum Lucy Ronca and her children George, and they're right at the front of my desk, the delicious Iris, who will do whatever she chooses to do over the next couple of minutes. But first of all, let me ask you, Lucy, do you think, because both of them have the allergy, that earlier detection would have helped you running the family and running their lives?
Absolutely. George was 4 months old when he was finally diagnosed with CMPA. And those 4 months were very miserable, actually.
And was the diagnosis a matter of him, and in her case as well, becoming ill or rejecting stuff? How serious is that?
So, looking back, his were pretty apparent almost immediately. Yeah. However, it was a gradual thing over time. Eczema, red raw skin, yeah. Rashes, vomiting, upset stomach, constipation, wind, reflux, colic... and, you know, all of those combined and gradually getting worse and worse and worse.
Let me put it to you, George, that everybody listening will have thought, well, that's good not to have all of those nasty illnesses and feeling rotten and what have you. But are there things that you quite fancy that you're not allowed to eat or drink?
I'm not allowed to drink milk.
No milk at all? Do your chums have milkshakes and things like that?
No.
So you don't really miss it? Ice lollies that have got milk in them? Yeah. Cereal? Can't have milk with cereal, can you? No. But life's OK, and you're feeling pretty fit. You're looking pretty fit. What's she like, who's now on the desk? Does she... She has to avoid the... You're all right, you just carry on there. And she can't have the milk either. Is it... I mean, joking apart, is it a nightmare to manage, or now you know, you just know what you can and can't do?
I think initially it's quite overwhelming, actually, because, you know, milk's in a lot of things. And one of the things that you're really concerned about as a parent is making sure that at a young age they're getting the calcium that they need. Yeah. So that was one of the things that actually, when we were finally referred into the hospital, having that support when weaning to making sure that they were getting the right food was absolutely crucial. And now, you know, we're able to make a lot of the safe... alternatives for them.
Brilliant. Good of you to share, and thank you very much indeed, all of you, for coming in.